Come with us now as we venture into yesteryear. Or was it yesterday?
Who cares?
We care, Alfred. Our cuddly little Bob Wilkins comforts us in moments of stress.
Wendy, I'm home.
No, it's true. Our short, cigar-smoking creature feature host always told us the truth about the films. Sometimes, the brutal truth.
The essential fact is, to get real suspense, you must let the audience have information.
Not to worry, Al. Bob always gave us information. Dependable, honest, straightforward, and serious.
I know you think I'm crazy, but in half an hour, the moon will rise, and I'll turn into a wolf.
You and 20 million other guys.
Join us now as our adult Dennis the Menace asks the musical question, creature features?
You really scared me. That's what you wanted.
Bob Wilkins and Creature Features is brought to you in part by Campbell's Soup, good food, and keeps getting better.
Can you feature that awful creature? Can you feature that ugly creature? Creature features and feature features about creatures. Creature features. Now the strangest thing about this show or two is its host, Bob Wilkins, and he brings it to you.
I think we have to fix that door over there. In fact, this whole place. When we started, the cobwebs were fake. Now they're real. Bob Wilkins here. What you just saw was scenes from an old creature feature show. Oh, I don't know how far back it went. I tried to forget all those movies and shows when I left Channel 2 years ago. One show I vividly recall, though, and that was my last program that I hosted, February 1979, and I remember it because the crew actually destroyed the set right as you viewers out there watched the program. I don't think the crew has moved that fast, that swiftly, since 1979, but I'm happy to be back this evening, and they tell me through the magic of all the electronic equipment here at Channel 2 that we will try to return to the golden years of creature features. This is amazing. They have recaptured the set perfectly. Just, it's amazing what Goodwill Industries can do on short notice, but Bob Roth and the floor department here, it even has the musty old smell. It's just a couple of changes. I used to sit over there, but I sort of like it back where you had me. There we go, see? I told you, a lot of magic equipment here tonight. I'm Bob Wilkins, and I used to host a creature feature movie here way back in 1971. And in 79, I sort of walked away from it all. And people have called the switchboard and said, why did Bob leave? And here's two reasons why I left.
The incredible two-headed transplant. A massive two-headed man monster threatening the most intimate terror any woman ever felt. Every woman his victim. Every man his enemy. The incredible two-headed transplant.
Brings back memories and a lot of headaches, too. And I guess a film expert, after I quit the show, analyzed all the movies I'd played over the years here at Channel 2, nearly 700 films. And how many do you think were where the audience could watch the whole thing, were airable, as we call in television? Four movies were worth watching, they said. That's amazing. You know, I had great reluctance to come back here this evening because you never know, you know, a lot of the people I used to work with are gone, or a lot of the old crew is in Ross Moore's Leisure World, bad hearing, the eyes are gone, everything like that. So you never know how you're going to be received. It's sort of like going back to a high school reunion. But I'll tell you, it was all heart here at Channel 2 tonight. When I came into the lobby, they had this sign made for me at great expense. Misspelled my last name, and they thought Pat McCormick was coming back, but it's a thought that counts. And they had some flowers for me there. Isn't that great? They're plastic. There's something about plastic flowers and television stations that sort of go together. And right here's a note that says, Bob, return these to the prop department as soon as you're through with them. Okay. Some of the other questions people had along the way, I guess when you're on television, people like to find out about your personal life and things of that nature. And they wanted to know what I've been doing since I left the station in 1979. And I hope to get into that during tonight's movie, which is a good movie, by the way. Okay? The Fog. John Carpenter's The Fog. We'll be talking about that in just a minute. But with all the electronic equipment that they have here at 2 now, something that I didn't have when I did the old show, we will be able to go around Northern California and pick up live entertainment or whatever we want to do. So I'm going to experiment with it tonight and try to bring back some of the things that you used to enjoy on Creature Features. In fact, if getting my cue now, we're going to go to beautiful downtown Oakland, the Hyatt Hotel, where one of the great singing groups of all time is performing right this minute.
Put you away, Bob. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Famous singing melons, and I know you probably think they're some creation of animation or special effects. They are an actual family from San Leandro, and they were one of your favorites years ago. They will open up, by the way, the new Fairmont Hotel in San Jose, so you can see them live there, and we may try to get back to them a little bit later in the show. With me tonight is a special guest and a friend of mine, longtime associate on the old Creature Feature Show, and Bob Shaw is with us, the film critic for Channel 2 now. Bob, you have a big job tomorrow night.
That's right.
Right. Bob is going to host the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. That's incredible. Right. Laugh about it now.
Yeah. Get it out of our system. Right.
Tell us about tonight's The Fog, though, John Carpenter's
Fog. The Fog was John Carpenter's follow-up to Halloween, a low-budget movie that ended up making millions of dollars and started the slasher horror films, mm-hmm. like Friday the 13th, went on for quite a while.
He's the guy we thank for all
that's
that.
Right. That's all John's fault. I really enjoy this movie. In fact, in retrospect, I like it better than Halloween. It's a very moody ghost story with pirates coming back and visiting a town that wronged them 100 years ago. Mm-hmm. And it's really well done, very technically
actually
proficient.
Filmed in Northern California.
That's right, up at Point Reyes, okay. The lighthouse up there.
Now, you told me off camera a little while ago that John Carpenter actually appears in the movie.
That's right. Right after the title of the film comes on, it says The Fog, the first guy you see is John Carpenter. He plays Hal Holbrook's janitor or something. They never really explain what he's doing there. Mm-hmm. He only has 4 lines in the film, but during those 4 lines he proves that he's no actor.
Okay. What, I want to talk, wait a minute, just this just in, Bob. Yes. Excuse me here. This is important. Again, one of our live camera feeds coming in, this time to Washington, D.C. in the White House. Apparently, President Reagan has an important message.
Here's great news about two wonderful Baraxo hand cleaning products. First, Baraxo powdered hand soap in a new plastic decorated container. Looks like this on the grocer shelf, and like this on your bathroom or kitchen sink. No rust marks, no messy soap dishes. Perfect for everyday hand washing for the whole family. And here's exciting new Baraxo waterless hand cleaner. Watch. I'll use some paint, some black shoe polish, and some dirty axle grease. Just a dab of Baraxo waterless hand cleaner removes the toughest dirt and stains, anytime. In the workshop, camping, on the road, anywhere. Without water, real convenience. New Baraxo waterless hand cleaner. And remember, Baraxo powdered hand soap. Both at your grocer's now.
Well, apparently that's the first time President Reagan has come clean on anything this year over television, and we're happy to be able to bring it to you here on our show. Back again with Bob Shaw real briefly, Bob. Carpenter actually married one of the stars.
Right, Adrienne Barbeau. He'd made a television movie with her called Someone Is Watching Me the year before, and he had her back to do The Fog, and I guess they got along real well, and they ended up getting married, and as far as I know, they're still together.
He must have liked her work, right?
Yes.
How would you rank this movie? I mean, you were with me all those years when we played the dogs on Creature Features. This actually is a good movie tonight.
It's very good. It's probably better than 99% of the movies you had. And this one is actually a television premiere tonight. And I don't think you ever had a television premiere on your old show.
No. I think, well, we had one. It was Jesse James Meets Frankenstein's Daughter.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. John Carradine.
Classic. There isn't a dry eye out there now remembering all those. Plan 9 from Outer Space. And
oh, yeah. Gosh. Attack of the Mushroom People.
Yeah, yeah.
How did you survive so long?
I don't know. But I got out while I was ahead. Bob, I want you to stick around. We're going to be using our live remote camera all this evening to bring you entertainment, see what's going on. We're going to be in Petaluma and El Cerrito and all over the place, San Mateo. And get a good seat out there tonight. Dim the lights a little bit because The Fog is an excellent movie. And we'll be back throughout the film, okay?